Good morning students, welcome to your data communication and computer network video class. In previous video I have discussed about guided transmission media and in this video I will discuss about unguided transmission media. After completion of this video, student will able to know about propagation method and different unguided media like radio waves, microwaves and infrareds. So let's start. First, what is unguided transmission? An unguided transmission transmits the electromagnetic wave without using any physical medium. Means in guided transmission, as we know, in guided transmission the signal are transmitted through a physical medium like twisted pair or coaxial or fiber optics. But in unguided transmission, the electromagnetic wave travels without any physical medium. So it is also known as wireless transmission. In unguided media, air is the media through which the electromagnetic energy can flow easily. Means here the media is air. Unguided media support electromagnetic waves without using a physical conductor. It is known as wireless communication. Without using any physical conductor, it is traveling, so it is known as wireless communication. And the signal broadcasts through free space and available to capable receiver. This is the figure of electromagnetic spectrum for wireless communication. Like for radio waves and microwaves, it uses 3 kHz to 300 GHz, and for infrared it uses 400 GHz. Then propagation method. Unguided signals travel from the source to destination in several ways. It is known as propagation. Means when the signal moves to any unguided media, in air, it is known as propagation method. And there are three propagation method, that is ground propagation, sky propagation and line of sight propagation. Okay, ground propagation is below 2 megahertz. And sky propagation is 2 to 30 megahertz, and line of sight propagation is above 30 megahertz. So in ground propagation, radio waves travel through the lowest portion of the atmosphere, touching the earth. In the ground propagation, it travels through the lowest portion, touching the earth. And in sky propagation, the radio waves radiate to the ionosphere, then they are reflected back to the earth. Okay, in sky propagation, it radiates to the ionosphere, then they are reflected back. That is known as sky propagation. Line of sight propagation means in straight line, directly from antenna to antenna. That is known as line of sight propagation. The unguided media are of three types: radio waves, microwaves and infrared. So let us discuss it one by one. First is radio wave. It is omnidirectional antenna, frequency between 3 kHz to 1 GHz, used for multicast communication such as radio and television and tagging system. In the case of radio waves, the sending and receiving antenna are not aligned. The waves sent by the sending antenna can be received by any receiving antenna. Okay, means in radio waves, the sending and receiving antenna are not in an aligned manner. They were sent by the sending antenna and it can be received by any receiving antenna. Radio waves can be penetrated building easily, so that widely used for indoor and outdoor communication. The radio waves can penetrate through the walls, so it can use in indoor and outdoor communication. An antenna is a structure that is generally a metallic object, maybe a wire or a group of wire, used to convert high frequency current into electromagnetic wave. Okay, so this way we use antenna to convert the high frequency current to electromagnetic wave. And there are two types of antenna. First is transmission antenna. Transmit radio frequency from transmitter. Radio frequency then convert into electromagnetic energy by the antenna and radiate into surrounding environment. So in transmission antenna, the radio frequency from the transmitter are converted into electromagnetic energy and transmit to the surrounding environment. And in reception antenna, electromagnetic energy get in antenna, the antenna convert the radio frequency to electrical energy, means just opposite of transmission antenna, and it goes to the receiver. And also same antenna can be used for transmission and reception. And radio wave application and advantage. A radio wave is useful for multicasting when there is one sender and many receiver. Like FM radio, television, cordless phone are example of radio waves. Radio transmission is mainly used for wide area network and mobile cellular phone. Radio waves cover a large area and they can be penetrate the wall. Radio transmission provide a higher transmission rate. So these are the advantage of radio waves application. And next is microwaves. Microwaves are ideal when large area need to be covered and there are no obstacles in the path. Microwaves are unidirectional. Microwaves electromagnetic wave having frequency between 1 GHz to 300 GHz. Microwaves are unidirectional. When an antenna transmit microwaves, they can be narrowly focused. This means that the sending and receiving antenna need to be aligned. Means in microwaves, the sending and receiving antenna must be in a aligned. Microwave propagation is line of sight. Means it will be, the antenna should be in a straight line. Since the tower with the mounted antenna need to be in direct sight of each other, repeaters are often needed for a long distance communication. Okay. Microwaves are widely used for one-to-one communication between sender and receiver. Example, cellular phone, satellite network and wireless. Means in microwaves, we know that microwaves are unidirectional. So the microwave propagation must be used line of sight. Means the two antenna must be aligned in a straight line. Then the last one is infrared. Frequency between 300 GHz to 400 terahertz used for short distance communication. Example, night vision camera, remote control, file sharing between two phones, communication between PC and peripheral device. Characteristic of infrared. It supports high bandwidth and hence the data rate will be very high. Infrared waves cannot penetrate the wall, means it cannot go through the wall. Therefore, the infrared communication in one room cannot be interrupted by near rooms. An infrared communication provide better security with minimum interference. Infrared communication is unreliable outside the building because the sun ray will interfere with the infrared waves. So this is all about the unguided media. The unguided media are of three types, like radio waves, microwaves, and infrared. Thank you.